Hachette Audio presents Tweak It. Small changes, big impact. Make what matters to you happen every day. Written by Cali Williams Yost. Read by Sarah Zimmerman. Dedication. For Andy, Emma, Maddie, and everyone who shared their work-life fit stories with me over the past 17 years, you are my inspiration. Introduction. Seven modern truths about work and life. Learn to live small, and you will discover great pleasures. You will accomplish more in your life than you could ever predict if you were overly ambitious. Thomas More. Work and life. As recently as 20 years ago, the rules that we all followed about when to work and when to manage everything else in life were pretty clear. Then the boundaries began to blur, and the rules started to change. Unfortunately, someone forgot to send the memo with the new guidelines. Every day we struggled to answer questions like, do I leave work a few minutes early to get to the gym or prepare for a meeting? Work from home in the evening to catch up on emails or meet a friend for coffee? Cover a coworker's shift or shop for food for the week? Ask for overtime or take my mother to the doctor? Catch up on paperwork or read at my child's school? Go to a lunchtime networking event or balance my checkbook? What if I told you there was a better way? The Tweak It practice outlined in this book will make what matters to you happen. This simple weekly routine of small, deliberate choices, or tweaks, will build the foundation of contentment, well-being, and order you crave, one step at a time. Imagine if over 1 year you managed to do your job, but also enjoyed lunches and a cup of coffee with your friends, updated your online professional profile on LinkedIn and attended a few networking events, kept track of your checking account and credit card purchases, took each of your kids to lunch or the movies one-on-one, made sure your backup childcare for the summer was in place before the last day of school, completed an online course to learn a new skill for your job, sent out presents and birthday cards on time, ate mostly healthy, simple meals, had a few date nights with your spouse or partner, made it to your annual physical, had your car serviced so it didn't break down from preventable problems and require costly repairs, took a walk with a group of friends or your dog a couple of times a week, got your hair cut regularly so you felt good about the way you look, and scheduled and took a vacation that let you disconnect the way you want to. You can. How do I know? For almost 2 decades, I've been on the front lines creating new, more modern, and flexible ways of managing work and life. I've worked with tens of thousands of individuals and hundreds of organizations, including J.P. Morgan Chase, JCPenney, Ernst & Young, the U.S. Navy, and the United Nations. I've given individuals the tools to create successful flexibility plans that change the way they work, through telecommuting or more flexible hours, in order to manage their lives off the job. And I've shown organizations how to use these same flexible work solutions to make their business more productive, save money, and provide better customer service. Over those years, I've learned 7 truths about work and life in our modern, hectic world. These truths challenge many of our long-standing core beliefs. The first 3 emerged as I began to study work-life issues in the early 1990s and continued up to the publication of my first book, Work-Life, Finding the Fit That's Right for You, Riverhead, in 2004. But as I promoted that book, I became aware of an important piece missing from the work-life puzzle. This discovery led me to the last four truths and, ultimately, to the Tweak It practice you'll find in this program. Before we go any further, it's important to note that Tweak It doesn't let employers and the government off the hook. Flexibility in the way work is done is critical if we, corporations, government, and individuals, are going to compete and succeed in today's highly competitive 24/7 global economy. Therefore, employers have to create work environments that truly support and encourage conversations about mutually beneficial, flexible work-life solutions. The government needs to update public policies that are woefully ill-suited to modern times. This includes outdated tax policies that penalize out-of-state teleworkers, overtime regulations that make it difficult for hourly non-exempt workers to access flexibility in the way they work, and a Social Security policy that penalizes working after you begin to draw benefits. And we, as individuals, need to learn how to reset the way work fits into life when we experience major life events like having a baby, caring for an aging adult, going back to school, or working in retirement. But none of these broader changes will succeed unless they are supported by a foundation of everyday contentment and order that only we can build for ourselves. This is why Tweak It is the important piece that's been missing from this big, complex puzzle until now. And it starts by acknowledging the seven modern truths about work and life. Truth number one. There is a new work+life reality for all of us. In the early 1990s, I was put in charge of the day-to-day management of a group of commercial bankers. At the time, there wasn't a need to train people how to fit work into the other parts of their lives. It was pretty clear. A workshop would have taken 3 minutes, including Q&A. When you walk in the door of the office at 9 a.m., Monday through Friday, that's when you begin work. After you walk out the door at 5 p.m., or when you're on your 2 guaranteed weeks of vacation when no one will be able to reach you, that's when you take care of everything else. If, for whatever reason, you can't walk in the door and work from 9 to 5 in the office Monday through Friday, then we don't want you. While it is true that not everyone in the early 1990s worked under these conditions, this was the standard set of rules that most people used to guide when they were supposed to work and when they were supposed to deal with the other responsibilities in their lives. But I began to notice a subtle shift. The reality of people's lives no longer matched those neat, rigid expectations. The growing mismatch caused people and business to suffer. But at the time, it felt like I was the only person who thought this was a problem that needed solving. I was a newly minted first-time manager overseeing a group of commercial bankers and administrators. I was married, but didn't have children, so I could work that Monday through Friday schedule for as many hours as I wanted. That wasn't the case for my staff and colleagues, many of whom had children. One day, my supervisor approached my desk and said, "You need to put Jack on probation." "What?" I responded with confusion. She continued, "Haven't you noticed he's coming in late, leaving early, taking long lunches and talking on the phone most of the day? And he's not booking any new business?" Naively, I pointed out, "Yes, but his wife just had a new baby, so I'm giving him some leeway." I was shocked by her response, which was something along the lines of, "We have hours and goals." In other words, new fathers get no flexibility. As it turned out, neither did new mothers. Around the same time, my colleague Linda had a baby. This was her first child in her recent second marriage. For more than a decade, she'd been a single mother who had successfully managed and grown some of the most high-profile accounts in the group. Before there was any formal announcement that Linda wasn't coming back from maternity leave, Linda's accounts were reassigned to me. Linda had chosen to.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.